So the ASEAN region, last year, when we saw the resurgence of yields going up, then a lot of the value stocks in the ASEAN region, particularly Singapore stocks, did quite well. But this year, basically, the resurgence of the COVID infections across the region has meant that it's taken a breather. Malaysia has obviously struggled a lot when it comes to both the fact that its glove manufacturers have not done well as global infections go down, but local infections are still rising. So I think for the ASEAN region to recover, you really need to see a pretty large disbursement of vaccinations. That's really what the markets and investors will be tracking. And from that perspective, Malaysia actually has secured most of its vaccine supply, which makes us a little bit more optimistic that, in the coming months, you will start to see that vaccination drive pick up in Malaysia, which could be a good opportunity to buy the market.
Okay, would that mean that as ASEAN comes back from the situation, that you would continue to hold your overweight position in South Korea and some of the other markets?
Yeah, so at the moment, South Korea and Brazil are our favorite markets in the emerging markets, predominantly because they are more linked to the global cycle as well as the commodity space. So until the ASEAN region is able to show that increase in vaccination, we probably will stick with the global export-oriented economies. But once you do see the infections and the vaccination drive increase in this part of the region, then certainly a sector, a country rotation is possible within portfolios.
Okay, what is the positioning on Chinese tech right now? And what are you telling clients?
So China has obviously been it has been very volatile last few months. From our perspective, we still think that macro policy as well as regulation still seems to be an overhang. Headwinds, not just in Chinese equities, but also in Chinese bonds, corporate credit is appearing to be the case. So at the moment, we are staying cautious. We really need to watch any further steps from the government. But for the time being, it doesn't look like the best place to be within emerging markets.